Good evening. I'd like to welcome everybody to the City of Thousand Oaks City Council meeting for Tuesday, January 23rd, 2018. If you'd all please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Ms. Rodriguez, could you call the roll for tonight's meeting, please?
Councilmember Bill De La Pena is absent. Councilmember Price?
Here.
Councilmember Adam?
Here.
Councilmember McCoy?
Present.
Mayor Fox?
Here. Item four is a request for any continuance for public hearing or agenda items. Do we have any requests for continuance? Hearing none. Moved to item five is special presentations. We have none. And that would move us to item six, which is public comment.
We currently do not have any public speakers at this time.
And that is a record. All right. Item seven is the consent calendar. Any items the council wants special? All right. Hearing none, do we have a motion for the consent calendar? Mr. Adam.
Thank you, Mayor. If there's nothing to pull, I move the consent calendar.
All right. Mr. Adam moves the consent calendar. Discussion? Hearing none, prepare to vote. Vote, please.
The motion passes 4-0, and I have an ordinance title for you. Ordinance reauthorizing city's public educational and governmental access support fee and amending section 7.2 of chapter 7 of Thousand Oaks ordinance number 1242 NS and 1511 NS respectively, ordinance number 1641 NS.
All right. Thank you, Madam Clerk. That is approved. We'll move to, we have no public hearing scheduled for tonight, so we move to item nine. That's department reports. We have one department report on economic development update, and with that, we'll have Hader Alawami is going to provide that report. Good evening, sir.
I'm just bringing up the presentation. Some technical difficulty here.
You know, if you're having technical difficulties, it's the only item on the agenda. We could adjourn at 6:10, and I could have the record for the rest of the time we were existing city. Yeah, we'd be unbroken, no doubt.
All right. Richard saved the date, or the date, or the night. Anyway, thank you. I'm here tonight to share information regarding the city's economic development program and present a snapshot of the local economic activities in the city. As you may recall, in September last year, the economic development strategic plan was presented by Cosmont Companies and approved by the City Council. Tonight, I will also briefly review the 12th recommendation in the plan, including the establishment of a Council Economic Development Ad Hoc Committee. So what we are about, the city's economic development activities revolve around three key elements or areas, supporting local businesses, attracting new businesses, and assisting the retention and our expansion of existing businesses. That's the core areas of our economic development program. With regard to how the city helping small businesses or business in general, as your economic development manager, I engage in activities in support of the council goals and priorities when it comes to economic development. Daily, I get calls from owners, brokers, and businesses about starting up a new business or relocating their business to another location. I listen to their ideas and provide input regarding city's process and requirements. And then I provide direct communication with city staff and other departments who can help them with their requirements, including public works, split building, whatever they need to move forward with their project. And then assist those businesses with city's application and permitting process, explain to them what the process is and what they need to do. And if needed, if they need expedited processing of entitlements due to a deadline they have to move out from their space or financial deadlines, then at least we have an idea that, that there's a deadline we have to work with. So by that way we can help them move a little bit faster and get their what they need to be done. So these daily services increase the local job base, which contribute to our diversified economy and the quality of life. Now I'll present a snapshot of our local economy, and it goes to 2017, what happened in the city locally. First of all, key demographic indicators in the city. As you can see from these numbers, the majority of the city's population is older, with a high median income and a high homeowner ownership rate. It is also higher and has a higher educated population. In comparison, the city to the county, owner-occupied homeowners in the county is 63.4%. We're at 70%. And the median age of the county is 37.5%. We are at 42.8%. So that we do have an aging population in Thousand Oaks. According to U.S. Census Bureau, American Community Survey 2016, which came out just recently, Thousand Oaks is ranked 23rd out of 200 cities in the nation as the most educated city in the nation. Those indicators you see before you are the highest among cities in the county for the city of Thousand Oaks. Vacancies. Again, you see the numbers. The reason for the high vacancy for the office is some of the older office buildings has not been renovated or updated to accommodate the needs of the users. And that's why some of them are struggling to get occupied. The newer office building that's been built, Class A offices on Townsgate Road next to the Hyatt Hotel, as soon as they constructed, they're soon after they've been occupied. There is a demand for A-class offices and not older ones. With regard to the retail vacancy, that will be a challenge in the coming years because, as everybody knows, with the shift, retail shift to e-commerce. So that's going to be a challenge. It could be a constant rate for a while until things happen in the economy. Otherwise, we expect that maybe to go up a little bit more before it's stabilized. Residential vacancy, it used to be 2% in December of 2016, gone down to 1.6%. And that shows a tight market for rental apartments, or rental units here in the city of Thousand Oaks. Sales tax revenue for the city, as you can see from the chart, sales tax been increasing over the past few years. And that's an indication of a strong economy in the city of Thousand Oaks. Sales tax, of course, accounts for almost 30% of the city's budget. Transit occupancy tax, the chart again shows an increase. There's a spike in 15-16, and that's for the Leeson Canyon. When there was a leak, a lot of people moved to the Conejo Valley to stay, so that's a spike in there, but it's expected again to increase over the years because of the activity of the Conejo Valley Tourism District. They've been active in going out and joining shows and trade shows for wedding travelers, so they're bringing more tourism activities to the city. Unemployment rate for the city of Thousand Oaks has declined from 5% in 2016 to 3.7% in 2017. Again, that number is with all respect is at almost at full employment, is considered to be at full employment. The city added 800 employees during the year. So, again, and we expect the job to grow, hopefully, with the additional industrial building that's undergoing in Thousand Oaks. However, because this chart shows the fact that not everybody who works here or who lives here work here in Thousand Oaks. Almost 70% of the workforce, residents of Thousand Oaks who are in the workforce commute outside of the city, and 30% live and work in Thousand Oaks. So that just play into the factor of many, many issues that the city and the region is facing. Now I would like to talk about recent significant private investments in the city's major employment centers, including Amgen, shopping malls, and the auto mall. Amgen is investing over $300 million in their campus by upgrading their workspace in their building. Eventually, when they completed those investments, they will be relocating their employees from the buildings that's outside the campus to the campus. And that's, again, an indicative of their commitment to City of Thousand Oaks by staying here and investing a significant amount of money in their campus. It's a Fortune 500 company. It's the largest private employer in Thousand Oaks with approximately 5,125 employees and an estimated 2,000 contractors that are on campus most of the time that works for Amgen. Westlake Plaza renovation, Regency Center went through a major renovation that was completed last year with over $20 million invested, including exterior renovation to the buildings and parking lot improvements. They added several outdoor gathering spaces for the community, which, as you must know, the community is enjoying those spaces, and added 12 new tenants to the shopping center since they completed the renovation. Westlake Promenade, the latest addition to the promenade is Nike Store, which occupied the old Sports Authority site, and that's a great addition to the center. And the former Macaroni and Grill restaurant closed, and they turned that into more retail. And that shows some of the need for retail spaces at that center. Vintage Grocers opened, and that's been a big asset to that shopping center. And recently, Tesla installed 25 charging stations at the shopping in the parking lot next to Sinopolis. And that will hopefully, people, when they charge, they'll be able to stay, go to a movie or go to a restaurant and be spending money, hopefully, at the mall. Oakbrook Plaza, again, Regency Center, just recently last year completed the renovation of their portion of Oakbrook Plaza. There's several property owners there, but Regency renovated their center, their portion, and they, with parking lot improvement, landscaping, and also added Gilson Market, opened a second store in the city at that center. And because of their renovation, other property owners now been motivated to upgrade their portion of the center. They've been asking Regency Center for contact information about architect and contractor. So that's a good sign that the renovation will be continuing. The Oaks Mall, Apple Store doubled their space at the Oaks Mall. And with the closure, unfortunately, of Simi Valley Apple Store, we expect to that our store here in the city will add significant sales tax to the city because of that. And then the outdoor patio area finally completed with the restaurants next to Movico, which includes Urban Plates, Chipotle, and Pizza Rev. And the Oaks Mall or Maestridge been given a green building certification because of their effort in sustainability and energy conservation. And then the Cheesecake Factory just completed their indoor and outdoor expansion, which, again, it's such a popular restaurant that this hopefully will help their businesses. John's Marketplace, a new business that just opened in the mall, include Dojo Boom Trampoline. Hopefully people had the chance to go check it out. It's fun for the family. Petco just moved in from Lincoln Oaks. Alta Beauty is an addition to the city and to the Giants Marketplace. And Dave and Buster's, even though it's not in the Jens Marketplace property, it's adjacent to it. It's they're taking over Sports Authority next to DSW Shoes and Nordstrom Rack. They filed their application, and staff is in the process of working with them and moving forward with that. Regal Cinemas just upgraded their seating area, which made it more attractive and more nice theater than the old style. And Jens Marketplace also is in the process of doing exterior renovation to their shopping center to improve pedestrian connectivity and add an outdoor seating area. The Auto Mall, again, the Auto Mall is a major sales tax generator for the city of Thousand Oaks. Last December, almost 2,200 new cars being sold at the Auto Mall, and that includes Toyota as part of the auto sales. Almost 21,700 cars were sold in 2017. That's an average of 1,800 cars a month per year, new cars. New Jaguar Land Rover dealership is under construction, and Lexus dealership just completed last year, which is a high-end, state-of-the-art building. And Mercedes AMG showroom is almost completed as well, and that's going to be a great addition for the city. Sports Academy facility that opened on Rancho Cuneo Boulevard is a state-of-the-art, one-of-a-kind facility in the nation. They attract a lot of youth sports. It's one-stop shop for athletes. They're also attracting a lot of professional athletes from basketball, baseball, football for conditioning and training, and future recruits as well. They come to the facility to be trained and be ready for their season. Five out of the private companies in Thousand Oaks are listed as the largest 25 profit companies in the Tri-County. Amgen came in at number second, Anthem Blue Cross at number four, Cal Lutheran University as number eight, Los Robles Hospital number nine, and Shire, which used to be Back Celta, number 14. With regard to our specific plan, as you know, the council adopted Thousand Oaks Boulevard specific plan in 2011 with the goal of creating a pedestrian, walkable, friendly environment with mixed-use projects. In the last 2 years, there has been three mixed-use projects proposed. One is under construction, which is the old Luby's restaurant, and two will be considered later this year by the Planning Commission, City Council, and staff as well. The Boulevard specific plan is discussed in the Economic Development Strategic Plan as an area of future growth for the city. And taking advantage of the assets within the Boulevard, the council approved a contract with Remy and Associates to prepare a master plan or a downtown core plan within the specific plan to create a destination gathering space for the community. And that area is between Herbs Road and Cuneo School Road. And this plan will be presented to the City Council in the near future, within 2 or 3 months to Council, and to provide direction to staff. The other area that was mentioned in the Economic Development Strategic Plan as a potential growth area is the Rancho Cuneo industrial area. And currently there are two projects. One of them is almost completed, and that's the Cirrus Regis Cuneo Spectrum Business Park. It contains nine buildings with over 500,000 square feet. And one of the exciting companies that taken over one of the buildings, Atara Biotherapeutics. Atara Biotherapeutics is a spin-off company from Amgen with Kleiner, Perkins, Caulfield, and Bayers. They got together and they spin off this company. And right now they're located in Westlake Village. They were in Thousand Oaks. They moved to Westlake Village. Now we're dragging them back to Thousand Oaks. The company specializes in innovative cellular therapies for patients with chronic diseases in therapeutic areas, including nephrology and oncology. This is cutting-edge technology, and the staff is really excited about the potential of this company and coming to the Thousand Oaks and the potential growth that they will provide. There was a choice between us or the Bay Area, and they chose Thousand Oaks. So we're glad that they've done that. The other project that is proposed in that industrial area is Chappelle. Chappelle, as you know, used to develop a lot of residential projects. Now they're focusing on industrial commercial. And they met with staff several times. They're proposing to build 16 industrial buildings. Again, all of these buildings are state-of-the-art buildings with over 800,000 square feet of additional industrial building. And this project, again, the combination of the two projects, we estimate to be creating over 1,000 employees. So that will be a great addition for our economy. As the city moves forward with the implementation of the economic development goals, staff will be reaching out to local stakeholders to be involved in the process. And as you can see from the slide, there's a talk about the CLU Hub 101, Ventura Bioscience, 805 Startups. Those organizations have been doing their own work with events, with competition, and hopefully in the future with the Economic Development Strategic Plan, we'll be able to utilize their skills, their knowledge, to move forward with the implementation of some of those goals. Tourism District, in 2013, the City of Thousand Oaks, along with Agora Hills, in collaboration with the Conejo Valley Chamber of Commerce, created the Conejo Valley Tourism District. The goal of the district is to increase hotel room occupancy in the Conejo Valley between Thousand Oaks and Agora Hills, and to increase the tourism activity in the city. And they've been successful so far, and that's you can see the result in the chart that I showed you with regard to the TOT increase. So they will continue doing that. And last Tuesday, actually, the Chamber of Commerce, the Tourism District, approved an exclusive agreement with Sports Academy to provide accommodations, hotel accommodation, hotel rooms, for the expected increase in Sports Academy tour. Youth sports tournaments. They're going to be bringing a lot of different youth tournaments to the city starting this year. So they signed the agreement with the Tourism District to be part of the growth of the Sports Academy and the need for rooms within the city. There are several economic development initiatives that will be undertaken by staff this year, and that include number one goal for the city council, and that's working with the Rams organization to find a location for them here in Thousand Oaks. With the successful season, hopefully it is successful for them, they will be able to pay some attention to us and come down and talk to us. But we've been in constant contact with them the last year, and they've been receptive to our comments and our discussion regarding permanent location for them. In 2 to 3 months, the recruitment for economic development analyst will be completed, and that position will be helping me implementing the economic development programs, the goals, as well as working with the economic development committee that we'll be talking about later and implementing the goals of the strategic plan, as well as updating our marketing materials, both in print and digital. We used to have print material that's hasn't been used or hasn't been widely distributed. So we'll be focusing on updating those materials and just to distribute them to interested companies who wants to come to Thousand Oaks, letting them know what's going on here in our city. And then, let's see. City staff will be working with the police department and our local social services partners in addressing some of the issues related to homelessness and transient population here in the city of Thousand Oaks. Some of the issues are impacting local businesses in the city with regard to their operation and to the future recruitment of businesses. So I know this has been an ongoing issue for the city and statewide, but hopefully we'll be working with our partners to create a program or create something that will minimize the impact to our local businesses. For our local economy to thrive and sustain the financial future for the city, there are three main pillars that must be maintained by our city. The city already has a great environment, quality of life, open space, excellent school system, and one of the safest cities in the nation. So that's, we already have that, and it's been one of our assets. The second pillar is jobs, and as mentioned, with regard to the city's employment of 3.7%, again, which might be considered full employment, that's a good thing for the city of Thousand Oaks. And with the additional jobs expected with those industrial buildings in the Rancho Cuneja area, there will be an increase of additional jobs in the city. The third pillar is housing. Opportunities will allow for different housing mixes to be constructed in the city, to accommodate the demand for housing, and that will support economic development. This message has been delivered to staff as well as council members by from our local companies who are looking to recruit high-quality employees, but they cannot find enough housing for them or affordable housing for them. So this is important moving forward with regard to balance, again, balancing the job and the housing market. With these three elements that will contribute to the high quality of life that we have for our current population as well as the future generation. As I mentioned, the City Council last September approved the Economic Development Strategic Plan. The plan is a long-term vision that focuses on economic growth for the city in the next 10 years. The plan contains 12 strategic recommendations that, if implemented, will contribute to the strength of our local economy. Those recommendations, just briefly, some of them has already been completed. Comprehensive update of Measure E, which was done already. An update of our general plan, which staff will be bringing that to the City Council soon. Development Opportunity Reserve, which deals with development rights and development potential for certain sites. Mixed-use development on primary location. Primary shopping centers, again, because of the e-commerce, there's a lot of impact in shopping centers throughout Southern California or the country. So the property owner of shopping centers looking at different uses in their centers, and they moving forward towards mixed-use project, including residential. Improved infrastructure in the Rancho Cuneja industrial area. There needs to some sidewalks, some intersection improvements. And that could be done through enhanced infrastructure district or PACE, property assessment, clean energy finance, that could which could include upgrading those older buildings to make them more energy efficient. Identify locations within the city to accommodate future growth that's different than what's traditionally been at that site, and that's the. There's a map in the Economic Development Strategic Plan that shows six potential sites within the city. And then consider the creation of new technology business opportunities. And that will go along with the Innovation Campus Research Park. And that's what I mentioned about those assets that we have in the city. We need to use them to be part of this initiative to again, because they are out there doing the work, we need to make sure we connect them together and create and implement this recommendation. And again, work and support CLU with regard to their desire to be within the downtown area. They really want to be a partner in the downtown improvements, so we'll be working with them on that. And then opportunities, area sites, again, within the city that could be potentially for future growth. And the last recommendation in the strategic plan is the creation of a council committee to implement and work with staff on those 11 recommendations moving forward. So with that, staff recommends that the City Council establish an ad hoc committee tonight with two council members to guide the implementation of the goals of the Economic Development Strategic Plan. And part of the work plan of this committee will be presenting a biannual report progress to the full council. That's my presentation. If you have any questions.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Aluwami. Questions for Mr. Aluwami or the staff? Go back to the thing. We have Mr. Adam, then Mr. Price. Mr. Adam.
Thank you, Mayor Fox. Really more a couple of comments. First of all, I want to thank Hayter for his dedication to economic development here in the city of Thousand Oaks. You've done an excellent job, and I can tell you from firsthand experience, Hayter is very well liked and very well respected in the business community. So thank you very much for that. And I think it's high time for this committee. Hayter could use a little help out there. I mean, a good economy means a viable and livable community. It means getting the kind of services and the kind of amenities that the people of Thousand Oaks expect, and that's why we need to start this committee to make sure we can continue to do that. The committee needs to be consistent in its efforts to foster economic growth and especially to develop some of these opportunity sites that were cited in the program. The study mentioned an interesting proposition, you know, in one of their paragraphs. You know, do we want to remain with the status quo? Do we want to remain as a retirement-leaning, older population city? Or do we want to look to foster residential growth that offers different opportunities for multiple generations? And I think the first path is, in the long run, is basically unsustainable. And I hate to see some of those city services and some of the amenities diminish if we follow that path. I really think we need to follow the path of growth and attracting multiple generations. We need to get our share of millennials here in the city. You know, there's 83 million millennials out there, and they spend a lot of money. We're under millennialed. We have about 15% of our population is millennials. Most cities have around 25% or so. And believe me, from talking to big companies in the city like Amgen and Infi and Skyworks and Cirrus and Shire, they're looking to us to foster the kind of economic development that are going to attract young people such as this. I mentioned those opportunity sites. That's a very exciting proposition here for the city. I mean, we've all seen the Kmart site languishing for a long time. There needs to be some work done there. We have our own West Side property that we can look at. The Pinecrest property, some of the properties next to the mall, the old Black Angus property, and the Armstrongs. These are blighted properties that need to be developed in a proper way to help benefit the community. And I think this Economic Development Committee can really assist to that. And finally, I just speak to Amgen, which is really crucial to our economy, not to mention the economy of the county of Ventura, our biggest employer. Amgen, like a lot of companies, has a lot of money overseas, about $39 billion at last count overseas. Because of the new Tax Reform Act, they're going to pay the lower taxes on that and repatriate that money back into the United States. I've heard anything from most of it to all of it. That's $39 billion heading into, hopefully, here in Thousand Oaks. And I'd like to see this development committee get a handle on what that might mean for the city of Thousand Oaks. Is that going to mean more capital expenditures from Amgen? Is that going to mean more hiring? Is it going to mean more startups, potentially, a biotech hub, you know, and I think this committee needs to approach Amgen to find out just what that might mean and how that might benefit the city of Thousand Oaks. I mean, after all, Amgen is a prime mover in this city. We want to see the company stay here. We don't want Tampa to be taking any more jobs than they already have, and so I think it's very important that we approach that. And finally, I'll just say that we're a very lucky city. Well, luck is a pejorative word, but a fortunate city in the sense that out of the 10 number one employers in the Tri-County area, we have four of them. We have Amgen, we have Anthem Blue Cross, California Lutheran, Las Robles Hospital. That's 11,000 jobs that these four provide for the city of Thousand Oaks. So I think it's very important that we maintain a dialogue with these people, that we partner with them. How can we retain them? How can we grow these companies because they mean so much to our economy. And finally, Hayter mentioned the Rancho Conejo site. That's very exciting. I mean, 25 buildings, 1.25 million square feet of commercial space. I think the area's probably could use some infrastructure work that the city could take care of. So this is how we can partner to make sure that that area is a big success and a big boon to the residents of Thousand Oaks. So that's my spiel. And what I would like to do at this point, as I did in a prior meeting, is volunteer myself to be part of this committee. And because I strongly believe this is one of the most important things we can do. And I'd like to ask my fellow council member, Mr. Price, if he would be willing to serve as well. And then, of course, it'll be up to all of us to see if that's the way you want to go. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Adam. Mr. Price, I believe you're next, then Mr. McCoy, then Ms. Villalpena.
Well, I'll start with your last question there, because I think it was the only question that was in that long speech that you made there. But I would be honored and consider it a privilege to be able to serve on this committee for a number of reasons. As I've mentioned at previous meetings, several of the past previous meetings, these are exciting times for Thousand Oaks like we haven't seen before. We have an opportunity here to shape what the future looks like. And I know Councilmember Adam referred to increased housing, building housing, bringing in millennials. I want to, and I know that he meant to use this word, just didn't, controlled growth. We will continue to monitor the growth and ensure that it is done in a wise manner and one that is in keeping with the flavor of this community, because I know that is important to folks. But we need to be proactive. We haven't done that in the past. We haven't ever gone out and sought out businesses that we want to see in our city. We've left it up to developers to go out and find businesses to occupy their spaces. And I think it's high time that we, as a council, we as a city, decide what types of businesses we want to have here. And we go out and seek them out and let them know what opportunities exist here in Thousand Oaks. I suspect that a large number of them already know what they would have to gain here. You talked about the sales tax and that it is that's one of our largest, well, sales, auto mall sales, the largest sales tax producer in the city. But the other sales tax sources are, we do leak out into outside of the city of Thousand Oaks, into other areas of the county, and even into LA County too. And there are some of those businesses that are operating outside of our city that could potentially be brought in here. And we need to pursue those and keep our sales tax here where it belongs. And the last thing I want to close with is, and this is paying homage to Hayter a little bit more, because he does the job of three men and a small pony. Everybody out there in the community loves him. He doesn't live in the city. I would love to see him live here, but I can tell you this: he spends a lot of his off time in the city here as a member of the Rotary, and he's very, very active. So I want to thank you for all your hard work and what you have done to this point. Although I'm afraid to say that the work is yet to begin. So, thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Price. Mr. McCoy.
Yes, Hayter, quick question for you. In regards to the vacancy rate, office, industrial, retail, residential, what is it countywide? Do you have those numbers? Because citywide, 12.3% vacancy office, 1.6 industrial, 4.6 retail. Do we have the numbers countywide?
Office, I don't have the exact number, but they're less than 20% on office space. Industrial, 3-4%. Retail is the same as we are, around 5%. I don't know much about apartment vacancy in the county, but I'm sure overall the counties have a tight market for apartments.
And then in regards to hotel, our vacancy rate's low, what is the annual vacancy rate, or was that a question for Adam Haverstock?
It's actually room occupancy. Room occupancy being around 79-80% in the hotels, and that's pretty high.
Okay.
For hotels.
And then the retail vacancy rate went from 8% down to 4.6%. Is that correct?
Correct. Last couple of years, yes.
So there's no room for cannibalism there. I mean, we're in need of retail space.
Yes, we eventually we will, but again, with the change in the shift in the retail economy, I don't know if they're going to be. Additional retail, it might be an expansion of existing retail, but I don't see new retail coming out, at least traditional retail.
Okay, thank you.
Ms. Bill De La Pena.
Thank you, Mayor Fox. Mr. Alawami, thank you so much for a very thorough report. It is very exciting indeed, as my colleagues have said, to embark on an economic development of the city of Thousand Oaks that looks toward the future. And I'm going to quote my colleague here, Mr. McCoy. He and I are probably the two youngest council members on the dais, so maybe we are closer to the millennials. And
we are the youngest.
Yeah, we are. We should be on the committee. No. I would like to actually volunteer as well, because I think I do bring a unique perspective, and I have mentioned that already at the past council meeting that I am interested in because this is exciting. This is definitely something where a lot of community involvement will be required, public outreach. And I'm not going into all of the other details that my colleagues have gone into, because I would just repeat things. So this is something that I would be very interested as well. And as a comparison, we had when the arts merger was conducted, we had two veteran council members, not necessarily as involved in the arts as I am, work on this with great success, because they bring a different perspective. And I think that bringing a different perspective to this particular committee is going to be very beneficial, and therefore I would like to volunteer for this committee as well. And of course, I'll leave it up to the mayor to decide, and the council, of course. Thank you.
Yeah, just for clarification, the mayor recommends, the council approves. So it's really council decision on that.
That's why I mentioned the council, yes.
We're going to, so we have three volunteers for that. We do have a public comment card. So if there's no more questions, comments from the council at this point, let me go to the speaker cards. We have one speaker card, Nick Kidway. Mr. Kidway, good evening.
Good evening, Mayor Fox, City Council. I beg in the name of God, who is most beneficial, most merciful. My name is Nick Iqbal Kidwai. I'm a resident of Newberry Park and director concerned City of Thousand Oaks. At 4 p.m., there was supposed to be an economic meeting for two council members today, but it was canceled because they had other priorities, I would think. You would think that we have an entrepreneurial government starting from the top with Mr. Trump, with all this talk about economic development, even coming from Mr. Price, whom we admire for his law enforcement, that's why he got elected. This is going too much, because if you remember, Reagan said, I'm not a Republican, but he said a great thing. He said, you don't want to, the last things you in the English language you want to hear from someone is to say, I'm from the government and I'm here to help you. And this city is a prime example. The West Side, $1 a year. And I read the contract further. We will never get any money, because all the negative that has accumulated in the rent, that has to be first paid for before the taxpayers get paid. We have a council member who said that Amgen told him, give us a downtown. Is it up to Amgen to ask the council to do that? I was late coming here today, so I ran out with no tie. And I don't have apologized to my members. I don't have my real tie for the council. But Flintstones, I think nobody will complain about that. I also had an economic study from 1992 that is sitting on my desk. And if you don't believe it, here's the, if you can show that, I think it can come up. It just, it doesn't show up, but I think you know I'm not telling a falsehood. In fact, there was another study in 94 that warned, I mean, we paid $50,000 for it. I think I've given it to a council member, never heard anything back from the council member about the study. But they said that if you build all these things, we will have cannibalism, economic cannibalism in Newbury Park, and it's going on in full swing. I am so glad to hear the numbers that the vacancy rates are lower, but as somebody who lives there and shops, it doesn't seem right to me. I hope they are not being inflated. I'll just give you two examples. In fact, I sent some pages that are in the green packet. I sent this economic study thing. Is over? Time is flying. 3 minutes is over?
Thank you, Mr. Kidwai. That's the only speaker we have on this item. I don't believe we need anything else from staff. Let me just suggest to the council, let's first take these the item first, receive the economic development update, and then we'll deal with the committee second. So who has to move the receive and file for the staff report? Mr. Price.
Be happy to move the receive and file the staff report on the economic development report.
All right, Mr. Price moves. Discussion on his motion. Hearing none, prepare the vote.
The motion carries 5-0.
That is approved. In as much as we have three council members, I'm assuming all of you, you're not just throwing your name out there. You really, truly want to, you're all genuinely interested to serve on the committee. Is that correct? Okay. Let me offer this modest proposal. The next item on the agenda later on is the committee assignments, which we just follow the normal custom where the we send it out. Everybody signs up for the committees they're interested in. I take a look at it with staff and for the most part, try to keep everybody in the committees that they've been serving on for a while. What I'd like to propose is not taking action on this item two or on the item 12A so I can reevaluate existing committee assignments, incorporating that with this new committee assignment, and then sit down with the city staff and then come up with what I think is one of equity, taking into consider seniority, balance of the committees, the number of people that are serving on committees, all those things that we all look at. So if that's amenable to the council, Mr. Powers.
The only thing I would add, and this is in relation to the next item, is that we do have one new committee or new appointment, which is the Los Angeles Community Choice Clean Energy Board. And the next meeting for that is on February the 1st. So perhaps what I might recommend is I think Councilmember Bill De La Pena is currently slated in that role. And if it's the pleasure of the council so that we had representation at that meeting, we may want to consider it. I just wanted to put that on the
table.
That
makes total sense. Is there any issue with the council on that particular? Anybody have to take exception to that? All right, then we'll take that on the next agenda and make sure we have representation on that. If there's no objection from the council, then that's that would be my recommendation how we proceed. All right, hearing none, then we will not take item two, and that concludes that agenda item. And that would move us to item 12. We're going to continue that item until the next council meeting. If there's no objection, that'll be the order. Oh, except for, no, Ms. Bill, you know the name of the committee. You want to move for that one item?
Yes, that is the Los Angeles Community Choice Energy, and Thousand Oaks needs to be represented on this agency. And so I'm certainly honored to serve in that capacity.
All right. Ms. Bilda Pena moves, and that would to appoint her to that sole committee, and then we'll bring back the balance of the committee assignments at the next council meeting. Any further discussion on that? All right, hearing none, prepare the vote.
The motion carries 5-0.
All right. Thank the council for their patience in that. And then that concludes item 12. We moved to item 13, the city manager's report.
Thank you, Mayor Fox. Our next regularly scheduled city council meeting will be on Tuesday, the 6th of February. We currently have two special presentations slated, one recognition of Tony Hagopian for her years of service on the Thousand Oaks Library Foundation, and a commendation for our outgoing fire chief, Ted Smith, which we'll be doing that evening as well. Public hearing, resident golf cart programs and fees. And a single department report that's currently slated to be there, and that's a memorandum of understanding between the city and the Thousand Oaks Library Foundation, along with a report on the League of California Cities Policy Committee meeting from Councilmember Price. That's it for the meeting coming up on the 6th of February.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Powers. Item 14, we have two closed session items. City Attorney will address those items, and then we will be adjourning. I don't imagine we'll be making any comment after that.
That's correct. We have two closed session matters. Both of them are pursuant to Government Code Section 54956.9A, their conference with legal counsel on pending litigation. The first one is City of Thousand Oaks versus Ross Calkins, case 56-2016-0048-5039, and the second one is Surratt versus City of Thousand Oaks, case 56-2016-0049-0653, and I don't anticipate having anything to report.
Thank you, Ms. Noonan. That brings us to our adjournment. We will adjourn tonight's council meeting to our regularly scheduled council meeting for Tuesday, February 6, 2018. On behalf of the council, have a great week. We're adjourned.